So, we've created the clan now, and now we get to do a little bit further story development before we get into the clan management section of the game. This is something that you don't see in King of Dragon Pass or the original Six Ages. This is sort of like a precursor. This is a sort of an extension of the clan creation story. Now we're doing a bit more refining. So this is the 8th year of Brolarolf. Brolarolf. Yes, this chap. So he's a heroic leader. Currently 50 years old and is king of the Berenthteli. Berenthteli? There we go. I will one day pronounce one of these words correctly. He is joined with Garaskar and Celebos, Astragor, Relindia, Adalia. Adelda and Kara, or Kira. I think that's Kara. We'll go with Kara. So, these are fairly good leaders by the looks of things. They've all got at least one excellent trait. Oh, except for Astragor here. He's a bit rubbish. I mean, he's not dreadful, but... Yeah. Got a fairly good split of people here. Except for Astragor. Poor old Astragor. Anyway. King Vinlanth, the great grandson of Beren and Redalda, lost the tribal regalia and his life-fighting shape-stealers at the False King's Massacre. His son, Brolarolf, became king of your tribe. As the most powerful king in the valley, it was natural that he would call for unity against the Chaos Horde. When your neighbours refused, he launched a raid to make an example of one of them. Yeah, it's a pretty neat beard, isn't it? In fact, quite a few of them have good beards. I mean, I would even say Astragor's beard is fairly good. It's pretty natural, I guess you would say. There's a little bit of trimming going on there, I think, but... Yeah, I think he's the one that's, I guess Garskar's let his... beard grow a bit, but he's ornamented it a little bit. Anyway, so who are we going to antagonize at the start of this game and raid? Upholders of the Dead Yelm's ways, the chariot driving wheels, the hot-headed restive riders who used to be your kin, or our kin. The fickle Forosilvli, fellow Olanthi who never really accepted your sun worship, the warlike Vestantes, one of the summer tribes of Olanthi. Excuse me. Oh, don't mind me. Don't mind me choking there. Oh, dear. Sorry about that, guys. I'm fine. Oh, better have a sip of my drink here. Oh, dear. Yes, sorry. Anyway, as I was about to say, the wheels make a very enticing target to me. In our Six Ages playthrough, they were a relentless thorn in our side. Although we did get to a point where we were bullying them fairly frequently, they were pretty awkward to deal with. They're my first pick in this because, well, I mean, because of what happened in Six Ages. But let's see what the clan is saying. Riders and wheels worship bright Elmore. It's our fellow Orlanthi we must bring back into line. Once we were riders, but many of them still haven't forgiven us for joining with the Storm People. Hyalor said, choose your foes with care. He doesn't have any particular suggestions, though. We have an advantage over the Forasilvuli. There we go. I'll get these names correct one day, maybe. And the Vestantes. In that we ride and they don't. But Orlanth could favour either one of us. Yeah, the thing about the Orlanthi tribes is... well, as we can see up in the top right here, and to the left as well, further in the background, their heroes have a habit of flying. So, yeah. Honk. Who honked? Who was it? Oh, it's Sorrow. Hi, Sorrow. we need people to like us, not fear us, so Relindia is taking the pacifist approach. Not that surprising, considering she's an Analda worshipper. Finally, an entire tribe can attack... finally, the entire tribe can attack the chariot people. Adelda is shouting... kind of mirroring my sentiments. Kera has this to say. Baron and Redolda would never attack their own kin. So she's saying that don't attack the riders. Although Redolda was a storm worshipper, so don't know why she would be saying to attack the Orlanthi. Well, I think upholders of the Dead Yelm's ways, the chariot driving wheels, is the answer we go for on this one. If only to keep with tradition on bullying chariot people. Their sword-bladed chariots took a toll on the footmen, but fleet riders and airborne heroes soon turned the battle in our favour. Rolf returned home with much plunder. Relations between you and the wheels remain fraught to this day. But Rolf's hopes for unity remained a dream. 5 years later. About a year after Rolf's raided the wheels, Anulda's magic failed. People said the goddess was dead, taken by Nontrea, the undead emperor. Your fields barely produce more grain than you sow. Now, helpful winds and rains have ceased. The priests throughout the valley can't contact Orlanth. Whether your gods are dead, captive, or away fighting chaos, their temples no longer give normal benefits. Holy people say these sacred spots have residual magic, which you can keep alive by continuing to support them. Other people eye the sacrifices and think they could be better spent, or spent better, or on better things. God, that's not a sentence I probably would have written myself, but I'm not a writer, so let's try that again. Other people eye the sacrifices and think they could be spent on better things. There we go. So, do we continue worshipping Orlanth? Do we continue worshipping Anulda? Do we keep up the sacrifices to both gods, continue sacrificing to both gods but on a smaller scale, or do we let both temples fall into disrepair? Do we abandon the gods? Without Orlanth's kingship magic, it will be harder to rule our tribe. Nothing like this has happened before. It's hard to be certain what happened to gods when we cannot reach them. Each temple requires a sacrifice of 10 goods and 5 herds every year. You're all mistaken. They aren't dead. Astragor is pleading with us. We must remain true to the Earth Queen. Maintaining her temple will allow us to draw on her magic when we need it. When Beren married Redalda, Orlanth and Analda joined Elmul as our main deities. There are living gods we can sacrifice those sheep and valuables to help feed us. So, at this point, what do we do? I've also noticed there's a sudden lack of music on this event. Or at least the music has gotten really quiet. Yeah, I think the music's just gotten really quiet. Yeah, it has. Well, this is going to be a bit of a tricky situation. Personally, I think we either continue worshipping or don't worship at all. I don't think we should take half measures. And considering how we've been playing the games previously, we have been incredibly reliant on the gods in King of Dragon Pass and in Six Ages. So my instinct is to keep up the sacrifices to both gods. After all, we have said that we... Yes, exactly, Fist brings up exactly the point I was about to make. Hope is our chosen thread. We need to uphold it. Open the Necronomicon and call for the Deadites. Oh, dear. I mean, that might become an option later, Sorrow. But we'll have to see. We'll keep up the sacrifices to both gods. People were proud to keep up the faith, but were worried that this was an expensive decision. We maintained regular sacrifices to keep alive the flicker of magic that remained in their temples. Oh boy. This is a rather ominous image. Also, check out the kitty. That's a big cat. With the king and queen of the gods dead, tribal unity unraveled. Our tribe mates, the other Baroneth Telly clans, have flouted the king's authority for years, refusing to send worshippers to our temples to Orlanth and Arnalda, or pay even token tribute. It is time to respond. We vowed above all to restore the authority of the king. We considered it important to make the tribe what it once was. Or do we say the days of tribes have ended for good? Or do we say we vowed above all to survive, putting talk of kings and tribes behind us? Now, let's see what the clan have to say for this, but... Then I have a couple of words to add. We must have a strong king, of course, the king says, or else the clan cannot unite against the many threats we all face. Brola Rolf's father was slain and we lost his regalia. But we are still a tribe and should act like one. Tribes encourage trade, but we can still trade without a tribe. The other clans are still our people. This is a sign of how bad things have gotten. The Baroneth Teli tribe was once the brightest light in the valley. Arnaldo helped Orlanth to make the first tribe. We are stronger together, and the tribe is stronger still with a king. Baron and Redalda founded this tribe and made us the royal clan. Anyone who opposes the tribe opposes our founders. As life gets worse, survival is more important than lost glory. So, yes. We've got a few options here, and everyone brings up some fairly good points. However, if we're going to take our experience of the previous games into account, the days of tribes have ended for good is probably going to be seen as a bit of mindless doomsaying. As, well, we somewhat recently created another tribe in King of Dragon Pass, and I believe King of Dragon Pass takes place after this. So, yeah. I think option three is going to be a bit of a cursed option for us. Perhaps a bit of a noob check installed by the developers, perhaps. I could be wrong. I may be reading a little too deep into it, but that's what it feels like to me. So, I'm leaning towards either the first or second option. I mean, I guess sorrow is on a similar vein here. Murder is an option. Options 1, 2, and 4 all have the potential for murder in them. So there's that for you, sorrow. But, what is a king without a tribe to lead? I think that is my line of logic, and I may be thinking option two is how we should go. Attempt to reinstate the tribe, and with that, the authority of the king should soon follow. But we will need to lead by example. If that is to be successful. But I think we have it in us in order to do that, so we'll go with option two. People agreed that the tribe was key, though some wondered whether this was worthwhile without a strong king. Others said that we shouldn't overlook survival as a clan. They're all very fair and valid points. Oh, here we go. It's this image again. Okay. You know what? I'm going to... There we go. Just getting screenshots, because I don't think there are going to be any screenshots or any images online just yet. So I've got to get me some thumbnails for YouTube. Hello, YouTube. Anyway, it is now the 20th year of Rolf, which means he's probably in his Oh, early 60s, so yeah, he's not long for this world anymore. Anyway, survival continued to become harder, and the tribe continued to fall away. Although you keep sacrificing to Orlanthin and Ulda season after season, they're still dead, and more gods no longer respond to your sacrifices. Other clans distrust our traders ever since Aseris is dead. Lankomai no longer answers questions, and much knowledge has been lost as elders die before passing it on. Again, do we keep sacrificing to all the gods? Do we maintain at least one temple? Do we scale back sacrifices to Aseris and Lankomai? Or do we stop sacrificing to the dead gods? Oh dear. At least Elmol, the loyal sun, still shines. The only way to know for sure what happened to our gods is to ask the Lord of Knowledge. We should be sure to maintain his temple. Every temple requires an annual sacrifice of 10 goods and 5 herds. Shrines take 4 goods and 2 herds. First Anulda, then Orlanth, now Aseris and Lankomai. Poor old Astragor. We made the right decision before. We should continue to give Anulda proper worship. I didn't think it would be possible for things to get worse. Some say they are but sleeping. Either way, we have to make sure we can support the gods who still do answer. Well, once again, I think this is a neat... A case of all or nothing. I think personally we need to go with all, as previously we have hitched all our hopes and dreams on the gods in the previous games. I think stopping now might be a dangerous, at least for a first demo playthrough. So I think we'll keep sacrificing to all the gods. People were worried that this was an expensive decision. Maybe so, but that's just how we're gonna have to deal with it for now. And speaking of for now, I think that's going to be it for this episode. So for those of you on YouTube, take care and have fun.